Hi, welcome to Cipher Street. I'm Bruce Fenton.
And I'm Naomi Brockwell. And recently, Bruce and I went to the MIT Bitcoin Expo, where we chatted with Nic Carter. Nic Carter, he's a partner at Castle Island Ventures. In your hand here, you've got this die. Now, Nic actually had these made, and they're pretty fun. He goes over
what they are. That's a brilliant idea.
Each side has a common argument that people use against Bitcoin, generally people who don't know too much about it. It's kind of a fun game.
Yeah, it is. One reason this is so popular, other than just being cool and geeky, is that these kind of objections, talking about things like, you know, Bitcoin can't work because it has no CEO or Silk Road, these kind of negative items have been thought of as reasons that Bitcoin will fail for years. And Bitcoin has continued to grow despite this.
Here is the interview with Nic. What have we got here?
So these are 12-sided dice. If you play Dungeons and Dragons, you'll know. The purpose is to make fun of journalists that like to trash Bitcoin. Last year, I made a meme with Photoshop, which was the Bitcoin critique dice, and all the comments were like, where can I buy this? I called up a dice studio that manufactures custom dice based in Poland, and I'm like, how much would it cost to make 500 dice?
Let's read through some of these because it's fantastic. No CEO.
Yeah, Bitcoin doesn't have a CEO, but that's... people consider that a risk, and Bitcoin has a governance problem.
We need a leader to tell us what to do. Yeah. Boiling oceans. I mean, the environmental cost, right?
That's my favorite
one.
Am
I right?
Yeah, Bitcoin using 0.01% of the world's electricity is really driving climate change,
Yeah, because, traditional financial industry doesn't use any
doesn't
energy at all.
Doesn't have an impact.
Yeah, it's wonderful how that works that way. Silk Road.
Yeah,
nefarious uses, but drugs are terrible. You can't put things into your body. That'd be awful.
Yeah.
Unstable fees.
It's just a very common line of attack is that Bitcoin fees will be unstable, which is actually, actually possible when block rewards go away.
Mm-hmm.
And the fees are the only source of revenue for miners. There are some interesting attacks that
so in 2140, we need to be really worried.
We're really going to have a problem.
Yeah, Satoshi coins.
Satoshi, if he's out there, he could dump his coins at any minute and just ruin Bitcoin.
Absolutely. And do we even know who he is? Like, he's probably planning this from the start. It's going to be a massive exit scam.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. China control.
Ooh, China. Because miners are in China, and that's very scary to a lot of people.
Doesn't scale.
I guess it doesn't. So maybe that
so,
one's right.
All right, you get this one. One out of 12.
we'll have to give that one to the critics.
But they're working on it.
Obviously, Lightning is the prototypical response, mm-hmm. but there are so many interesting sidechain experiments, too.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, I think Bitcoin works well for its niche use case today, mm-hmm. Even if it never were to scale.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's the most popular view. But
we've got the Gini coefficient.
So that's a very common line of attack is that the distribution of bitcoins is highly unequal and there's some whales that control all of them.
And that's a terrible thing too. I mean, who wants all of these people that have since gone on and started all of these businesses and just created an entire industry out of nothing where no jobs existed before? So that, terrible that those people...
Entrepreneurship should not be
rewarded.
Yeah,
terrible. Forks inflate.
Oh yeah, so that's an interesting one where the idea is that a fork is a copy of Bitcoin and actually inflates the supply. That sort of presupposes that forks are equally valid
mm-hmm.
copies of Bitcoin, which I don't think is the case. But
I was very surprised when Bitcoin Cash first forked that when you had the futures market emerge, you didn't see a detraction from the price of Bitcoin. Like, you'd expect that when something forks that it balances out anyway.
It'd be like a dividend payment.
Yeah, with Bitcoin Cash, it came out and kind of added to the value.
Yeah.
But then with other forks like BSV, from Bitcoin Cash, you did see that split.
Yeah, it was,
The value was definitely divided. So yeah, this idea that all forks inflate.
Yeah, not all forks are made equal. Bitcoin Cash, there was a real movement and community behind that one. But Bitcoin Gold and Bitcoin Diamond, I don't think have actually inflated the supply of Bitcoin.
Tether
was everyone's favorite stick to bash Bitcoin with.
Absolutely.
Even though Tether is just a token on Bitcoin. The claim was always that the money was in the bank account wasn't there. It had been created out of thin air. Obviously now we probably have some more confirmation that actually it is there and they have banking.
Well, I was always very interested in the fact that most of the FUD around Tether came out just prior to like a bunch of stable coins being released onto the market. You got to take all that with a grain of salt.
Yeah, no, it was all very, you know, clearly motivated.
Everyone has an agenda. No merchants.
Yeah, so there's, I guess there's no merchants that accept Bitcoin. Actually, now there are plenty of, and you know, even Lightning merchant services like OpenNode.
You know, so if you talk about your exposure to merchants, that's actually pretty high at the moment, where different people will take on the risk for you. You can pay in Bitcoin. Mm-hmm. They don't have to accept Bitcoin for it to be offered there. The final one.
That's the logo of my venture fund. So I had to get the subtle shill in there.
Well, thank you so much for chatting with me and talking me through all of the risks we may not be aware of with Bitcoin. So if you weren't scared before, I hope you're scared now with this 12-sided dice.
And you can buy them on the Lightning Network. You can buy them on Quinsolo or actually Casa on their store.